On behalf of Leaside United Church and Northlea United Church, welcome to our evening of carols and candlelight. This is our second year that we have brought our communities together for this annual Christmas celebration.
Thank you to Matt Buta from Leaside United Church and David Jaffelis from Northlea United Church for their creative and collaborative work together. Along with their leads and all of the choir members, your gift of music has been a blessing for all of us in the past and right now, and it will be in the future.
The Haudenosaunee, or the people of the Longhouse, have their own unique story of creation. It is a story of hospitality. When Sky Woman is sent from her home in the sky, she falls into the unknown, pregnant with seeds of life. The birds catch her and rest her on the back of a turtle, who allows her to make her home there. She is welcomed by all the creatures, and together they make a home called Turtle Island. We who are settlers or descendants of settlers were made welcome here on Turtle Island by the indigenous peoples. Our land acknowledgement recognizes how we are nourished by the roots of welcome and hospitality. Let us acknowledge, then, the history, spirituality, and culture of the First Nations peoples who were here long before us. And let us recognize with open hearts the many races and traditions that have been welcomed by this land and its inhabitants. May our respect for the land and its traditional spirit of welcome be with us during this time of celebration and in our generous giving as a response for the gift of welcome that we have received.
During Advent, we light candles on the Advent wreath as we anticipate welcoming the birth of Jesus and being welcomed by the love of God in return. On our first two Sundays, we lit the candles of hope and peace. On this third Sunday of Advent, we light the candle of joy. Joy that comes when we are welcomed with warmth and grace. Joy that arises when we hear the hymns and anthems of this joyous time of year. Joy that fills us when we are able to make room for new life among us. Joy of the birth of Christ, who is our source of hope, peace, and love. Let us pray. Spirit of joy, be present in this time that we share with one another, connected by computer screens, internet cables, and phone cords. Remind us of the joy that rests within, even in the midst of challenging time.
Be present in the stories we hear and the hope we share. Remind us that joy stretches through time and space, beckoning each of us to witness a human birth, that sacred everyday wonder.
Be present in the music we share with one another, from distanced choirs to the rich voices behind muted screens, songs resounding in empty rooms. Remind us that joy is vibrant and moves us into harmony with one another. Amen.
Come meet a baby who's surprised and disappointed. People called freedom, a prince to lead us, a prince to fight. Instead, here, God so tiny, so fragile, we're forced to protect life so precious. Here, love on the edges, travelers and refugees, vulnerable to power that crushes. And yet come meet a baby with our surprises and disappointments. People called tradition, the good old days, comfort. Instead, here, candles on screens, songs over phones, virtual community. Here, hope endures and love is strong in the most unlikely places. Come hear a story that through the centuries has carried people through plagues and famines, through wars and personal grief, a story of expectations overturned. Good news sung by terrifying messengers. Love on the edges. Love in the needing places. Love that makes the powerful weep, the vulnerable rejoice. Jesus Emmanuel, God with us. Come hear a story that pours into our living rooms, spills from our computer screens, suffuses the starlit streets. Love that demands we shed our expectations, scatter our traditions. Listen with all that we are, ears, thoughts, hearts, and become messengers, singing good news. A world transformed not according to our expectations, not out of our disappointments, but responding as if to an infant scream into the night. This is not right. Love is needed. Now.
Whoa. Whoa. Reading from Isaiah 11, verses 1 to 2 and 6 to 9. A shoot shall come out from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. The wolf shall live with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain. For the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea.
Thank you. A reading from the Gospel according to Luke, chapter 2, verses 4 through 7. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available to them.
The cold night air caused his little body to shiver. His eyes were barely open, but already the world seemed such an unwelcoming place. And then she held him close. He felt a familiar rhythm, a soothing vibration that he knew from inside her womb. A gentle reassurance filled him, and he allowed himself to relax in her arms. Love has a familiar heartbeat, calming, comforting. It opens its arms to our vulnerability and our weakness. Jesus returns once again to remind us, "Take care of my love," he tells us. "Protect it, nurture it, and share it with as many people as you can."
Both Northlea United Church and Leaside United Church have long traditions of carols by candlelight services where the offering is given to others who might be in particular need during this season.
Offerings shared with Northlea United Church will be donated to Youth Without Shelter. Offerings shared with Leaside United Church will go to Eastminster Out of the Cold program.
We'll be sharing information with both congregations about how to give, both in the video descriptions and through our church emails.
We give thanks now for all the gifts that we have received, and we offer them, O God, to the care of your people, those who are in need of comfort, shelter, and care. May they know your love this Christmas through the offerings that we give. In Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
Ding-dong, merrily on high, in heaven the bells are ringing. Ding-dong, merrily the sky is ridden with angels singing.
Luke 2, verses 8 through 20. And there were shepherds living out of the fields nearby, keeping over their flocks by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy to all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger. And suddenly a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests. When the angel had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. And when they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at the shepherds had said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had seen and heard, which were just as they had been told.
Let us pray. Holy mystery, breath of night and shimmer of stars, we long for your presence in the darkness and glow of candle flames. We long for your presence in long hugs, warm handshakes, and shared cups of coffee and tea. We long for your presence in crowds hushed to hear a choir and the echoes of organs. Yet this year we remember that you are present in the spaces of our lives, not just the sounds. We remember that you are present in how we give of ourselves, not just what we receive. We remember you are in the long nights as well as the bright days, and nothing can divide us from your love.
Holy mystery, breadth of sky and depth of sea, we bring our prayers for these times. We pray for our world and the hardship created by COVID-19 across the globe. We pray for all who are ill, all who have lost others, all who have worked tirelessly to offer care and compassion. We pray for countries struggling with case counts and for all places enduring natural disasters. We pray for communities disproportionately affected and resources inequitably shared. We pray all the prayers of our hearts.
Holy mystery, song in the silence and dream in the night. May we find opportunities for transformation for ourselves and our world. May we be reminders of your presence in unexpected people and places. And may we hear your song of love sounding through all of our lives. Amen.
And now let us pray the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us away from temptation, deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Thank you.
May the song of love be with you in this moment and every moment, filling your hearts and your lives. May the song of love be a call that echoes through the empty spaces and busy places. And may you become that song of love as well. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you.